again, this has become another problem. Parent will mean the child. Doctor, shall I give my child intranasal vaccine or injectable vaccine? You decide. So you have to tell them what are all the advantages and disadvantages. Below 3 years, you cannot give the intranasal vaccine. And the seroconversion is supposed to be 86 to 92% in nasal and 80 to 90%. They are comparable as far as the seroconversion rates are concerned. Local IgA and cell mediated immunity is supposed to be stimulated with the nasal vaccine. But again, this is supposed to be short lived. And we are going to, we don't expect any immunity to last for more than 1 year. And we do not know how the virus is also going to undergo the mutation in the next 1 year. Among the intramuscular inactivated vaccines, we have the splint virion vaccine and subunit vaccines. There is one company that is manufacturing only the H and the F. And they are supposed to be, the subunit vaccines are supposed to be less reactogenic compared to the splint virion vaccine. Before advising vaccination, do not forget basic preventive measures like covering the mouth and nose with tissue during coughing and sneezing, wearing a mask, hand washing, avoiding hugging and handshaking, and avoiding crowded places. I have a last.
Vector population or the mosquito. The major issue which I would like to point out is, unlike H3N2, which affects only people with a low immune efficiency, whereas H1N1 can affect younger individuals and it can be devastating in certain individuals who develop an interstitial pneumonia or an ARDS. We are sure it is going to protect for 1 year. Nothing is sure in life, sir. Are we sure we are going to get back home today, sir, with the traffic in Madras? I don't think Nothing is sure.
What are the side effects?
The side effects? I fully agree with you.
USA already it is well in there, and Russia made the vaccine. I fully approve of the point. I took a student from India to Russia. I took five to the both had the vaccination. And they landed in Minsk, where I can actually. The whole city was full of and full fever. And the whole year, the people were suffering. The boy told me from there. Thanks a lot that this year I was not the only person who was not affected by that. I was there for 4 days around him and around me in the flat where we stayed also they had. So it is definitely in USA also they are doing it every year, they are doing mass vaccination for this year, so as far as I know. The same principle only they are adapting for H1N1. We need not to suspect the efficacy now itself before it launched. It can be given now and then. Whatever way now it is available.
In year of two, we will definitely get more studies on the seroconversion. And which is better, which is, and how much long lasting the immunity is. All that will come in a year or two, sir. My only request is, let us not see when somebody can buy a ticket for Yandiran in black market for $300 or $1,000. They can jolly well have a swine flu vaccine. Do you think that your life is less precious than seeing Yandiran on day one? I can't understand the philosophy of our own brother.
So can I ask you two questions, please?
Yes, ma'am.
I just want to know why this virus has got particular predilection for the younger people who are more immunocompetent rather than immunoweak. There should be some reason.
That's right.
And then we will know how to protect this. That's number one. Number two, as far as pregnancy is concerned, I mean, I have listened to this thing. They are telling don't give in the first trimester. From second trimester onwards, you can. Previously, they said don't give. Now they are telling that from second trimester onwards, it can be given.
Live attenuated vaccine is contraindicated in
Anytime, yeah.
Killed, as you rightly say, see, we do not know. See, this is the first time we are using the vaccine. If we give right and left, we do not know the teratogenic potential of the vaccine. So we have to, I think, I won't blame anybody who wants to have it in the second trimester. So long as they're willing to have it, fine. Because pregnancy and obesity are supposed to be two factors which make the disease run a very nasty course.
I mean, I am in a very disinfectant unit. So far, whatever may be the, we see around 20 to 30 patients with very high temperature who we admit. And we found out of 30%, 27% are Plasmodium vivax malaria. It's the highest now.
See, I was involved in the Sentinel study on influenza. Seasonal flu, I was heckling at people because we collaborated through King Institute with CDC and took nasal swab and throat swab from my clinic throughout the year, not only in the winter months. As a cause for an acute upper respiratory infection in children, the seasonal flu H3N2 accounted only for 12 to 15%, which was much more. So the other viruses, like you know, your respiratory syncytial virus, your adenovirus, para influenza virus, there are so many viruses which give rise to. I do agree with you. See, the only problem is the case fatality rate, the nature of the virus to affect younger individuals, and more number of individuals with swine flu requiring hospitalization compared to seasonal flu. These are the things. I really do not know whether developing countries like ours with a huge population are being taken for a ride by the multinational companies to recover the money which they have spent in that research and development.
Yes.
That is one aspect of it. See, we are born in a country where we look at the corruption in the Commonwealth Games rather than the number of medals won by our athletes. So, we always have that sense because we are trained, you know, right from corruption is part of life in India. So, we always look at all that. My only thing is, if a man can afford it, he wants it, better give him the vaccine. Don't deny him the opportunity. If there is going to be an epidemic, it is the non-immune people who are going to be affected rather than the immune people. That's all. Yes, ma'am. The reason is, like, our children and older people are alike. Immunodeficiency, natural waning of the immunity is there when you become old. So we do not know how much of this attenuation is really attenuation. Again, being manufactured by an Indian company, you will have at the back of your mind some suspicion. Is it really attenuated? How attenuated it is? How many number of passages it has undergone? You know, all these questions will come.
Historically, the conventional seasonal vaccine, which was introduced decades ago and earlier, failed even at the end of epidemic. What are the scientific basis of its failure?
I don't think, sir. I know that much about the older incidents of, you know, the pandemics and why they failed. Probably Dr. Devanayakam much. CMD, sir.
Long time ago.
CMD, sir. Because I was just thinking, he is an epidemiologist, so he may be knowing more about the older flu episodes as well as the vaccination.
Why I am pointing out this, this is epidemiological field observation. The original vaccine that we introduced for the classical, of course I don't remember the numbers, the classical influenza failed in the end. Same way they introduced the encephalitis vaccine for the pigs, that also failed. They introduced in the beginning to successful but subsequently failed. Therefore, what I was thinking is, have we improved in our technology in the production of the vaccine so that we can assure the public that the present vaccine we are offering to you is better than the older ones?
I think that must be answered by a research worker.